Wherever you are, come on and bless the Lord. Come on and bless the Lord. Oh, give thanks. Come on and give thanks this morning. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercies are everlasting. I don't know about you this morning, Galilee, and your family and friends, but I'm chasing after God. How many of you are chasing? Come on, just give God a wave offering. Hallelujah. I'm chasing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You all to help me to sing this song this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm chasing. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, I want you to snap your fingers up. Put your hands together. Get your vocal cords ready. Amen. Are you ready at home? Come on. Huh? That's it. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. Come on, help me sing. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more, more. Chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. How many of you at home need him more and more? I'm chasing you. Yeah, that's it. I need you more and more. Come on, can I sing it again? I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more, more and more. I need you more. I'm chasing after you. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. I'm chasing after you. Come on, help me sing. I'm chasing after you. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm praising my way through just to be closer to you. I'm chasing after you. I'm chasing after you. I think you got it. I'm chasing after you. Hey! I'm praising my more, 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 yeah, yeah. chasing after you more and more. Jesus, I need you more and more, 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 more and more. Hallelujah. More. Are you grateful? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm grateful for all the things that the Lord has done. Come on and just give God a wave offering. I'm grateful. He's so faithful. I know that you know that, I believe it in my heart that you know that God is, he's faithful. He can do all things but fail. Oh, continue to help me to bless the Lord this morning. Forget about everything else and concentrate on him and his goodness and his grace and his mercy. Thank you. And praise you, Lord. I'm grateful for the victory won. I could go on and on and on and on and on about your words. Hey, because I'm grateful, so grateful, grateful just to praise you. Because you're so good. Yes, it is. It's flowing from my heart. Are the issues of my heart. Grateful, 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 grateful. Oh, think about it. It's grateful, 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 grateful. flowing from my heart. Come on, sing it. Grateful, 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 hey. Grateful, 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 grateful. Come on, think about it. Grateful, 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 gratefulness. It's flowing from my heart. Grateful, grateful, grateful. How grateful, grateful, grateful. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful. Oh, grateful, grateful. It's gratefulness. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's moving. It's moving. It's moving. It's moving. It's flowing. It's flowing. Flowing. It's flowing. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. His gratefulness. His gratefulness. His flowing from my heart. Grateful. 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 Jesus, oh yes I am. I'm grateful for your faithfulness, for your faithfulness. Yes, Jesus. It's flow, is it flowing from your heart? Hey, yes. I'm gonna ask you at home, is it flowing, is it flowing, is it flowing, is it flowing from your heart? Hey, oh, 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 oh. Is it flowing from your heart? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Are the issues my heart? Hallelujah.
Somebody can declare, I'm grateful for another day. I'm grateful for another opportunity. I'm grateful. The Lord has kept me, sustained me. I'm grateful I'm still here. What a blessing. This is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad. Paul helped us. He said, sometimes you just got to, I think myself happy. Somebody can declare, I got the right attitude, the right perspective, the right mindset. This is the day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. We're so grateful, appreciative you took the time to connect, to reach out. Listen, we serve an awesome God and truly worthy to be praised. I don't know about you, but I, like the psalmist, have to declare, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, trauma and drama, challenges and difficulties, and through it all, God has been faithful. I know there are a whole lot who can attest to and identify with the power of an awesome God. Listen, we continue to pray one for another in the midst of what we are experiencing in the midst of challenges, in the midst of seemingly uncertainty, in the midst, we still declare our God is worthy. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for privilege and opportunity today to once again connect and to hear from on high. Do now use your preacher to your glory and allow the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart to be acceptable in thy sight. Oh Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. Listen, as we gather today, I want to share with you on a topic that I think is very important and critical, especially in the times that we find ourselves in. The negativity, the challenges, the need to persevere in spite of. If you're not careful, even the strongest among us can grow weary in well-doing. That's right. I don't care your title. I don't care how many scriptures you can quote. The strongest among us can grow weary. And so today I want to, if we can, I want us to look at a particular scripture that kind of sets the tone that is necessary. Far too many are inundated, overcome by the troubles of the world. I mean, overcome with what they can't control, overcome by worry. Some of you know exactly what I'm talking about, worry. It's a real topic, worry. Worry does not discriminate. It doesn't care about your pedigree or where you grew up. Worry. It doesn't matter about your economic status, your title, or your net worth. No, worry can get best of us and the least of us, regardless of your gender or your political affiliation. Worry. Worry is real. Somebody knows what I'm talking about. Worry doesn't care if you are in a palace with riches or living in pure poverty. Worry. Worry is real. Worry will steal your joy. Worry will choke your praise. Worry. Worry will diminish your health. Worry will make you lose your mind. Hear me, far too many people think materialism alone, accumulating stuff, will be the end all. But listen, worry doesn't care how much stuff you have. You can live in a castle and still be cast down. I think you get what I'm saying. You can be living a life of quote unquote royalty and still be ragged. Rich and still ridiculous. Worry. You can live in a mansion and it still be a mess. Worry. I thought today, a whole lot of us will be better and blessed. Jesus has some instruction for all of us. It's found in the Gospel of Matthew, the 6th chapter. He's speaking and teaching. He's instructing and directing. Matthew, the 6th chapter. What is verse 25? You find these words, come with me, in the 25th verse of the 6th chapter of Matthew's gospel. Jesus is speaking and he lifts these words. Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold, the fowls of the air, they sow not, neither do they reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? Why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothed the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you? O ye of little faith. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Therefore, take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. I want to deal with, in our time here, I want to challenge all of us to focus on the subject. It's only two words, and that is overcoming worry. That's it. Overcoming worry. It's important. It's critical. Because worry is real. Overcoming worry. Jesus is instructing and teaching in the sixth chapter. And he's speaking to the challenges that the people face. And the challenges they faced then were the same, in many respects, challenges we face today. That which we cannot control. Jesus is speaking and he's teaching and instructing. And he wants to get their attitude and perspective in the proper place. Look at him. Hear him. I want to read from the Message Bible. It says it this way. If you decide for God, that's verse 25, living a life of God worship, it follows that you don't fuss about what's on the table at mealtime or whether the clothes in your closet are in fashion. There is far more to your life than the food you put in your stomach, more to your hang on your body. Jesus is saying, don't get it twisted. Don't major in the minors. Don't get confused. In other words, you and I have to be clear. God's got our back. I don't know who I'm talking to, but today is the day that you got to come to the realization if you're going to be steady and stable, God's got my back. There are too many challenges that we face daily, too many things that can shake us if we're not careful to keep our eyes on the prize. To believe if God be for me, who can be against me? Jesus is teaching and speaking, and he wants those who are his hearers to get their attitude and their perspective on life correct. Therefore, I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on it. Is not the life more than meat and the body than raiment? Don't get caught up in the stuff. Praise his name. I can't tell you how many times I encountered and dealt with people who get caught up in the stuff, get caught up in materialism, get caught up in money, get caught up in the things that the world highlights but really won't matter. Today is the day somebody is set free. Today is the day somebody's going to receive this reality that there are some things money cannot buy. That's right. Money can give you a palace and it can be palatial, but money still can't give you peace. There are some things money cannot buy. That's why far too many people live a life talking about one day. If I can only get this, or when I only get that, or when my payday comes in, then I'm going to start living. Sister, brother, you better learn how to live in the now. You better learn how to handle what God has given you. You better learn how to thank him for what you do have. And you can't wait for one day, because one day may never come. You got to learn how to maximize that which the Lord has put under your domain. How to thank him for what you presently have. Somebody knows exactly what I'm talking about. You know people who are always talking about if I could only. If I coulda, woulda, and shoulda. Their life is always one day. Thusly, they never live. They never get the most out of the present. And that's just what it is, the present. This text Jesus is teaching. He knows that in life, anxiety can get the best of you. Worry is the sin of distrusting the promise and the providence of God. Worry. At some point, you got to understand that there's still power in prayer. And if I'm going to pray, I'm not going to worry. But if I'm going to worry, I'm not going to pray. Worry. Let me share with you. It has been reported that a dense fog extensive enough to cover 7 city blocks 100 feet deep is composed of less than 1 glass of water. Divided into 60,000 million droplets in the right form, a few gallons of water can cripple a large city. Did you catch that? It has been reported, I'm going to say it again, that a dense fog extensive enough to cover 7 city blocks 100 feet deep is composed of less than 1 glass of water. Divided into 60,000 million droplets in the right form, a few gallons of water can cripple a large city. In a similar way, the substance of worry is nearly always extremely small compared to the size it forms in our minds and the damage it does in our lives. Someone has said worry is a thin stream of fear that trickles through the mind, which, if encouraged, will cut a channel so wide that all other thoughts will be drained out. Worry will mess you up. Worry will cripple you. Worry will destroy you. Worry will defeat you. Somebody today, here and now, is going to make a decision. I will overcome worry. I'm not going to get caught up in it. I'm not going to let it cripple me. I'm not going to let it mess me up. Worry will make you lose your mind. Worry will choke your praise. Worry will steal your joy. Today is the day a whole lot of people are going to make a decision. I'm overcoming worry. Look at Jesus' teaching. He's sharing. By verse 26, after he's highlighted these pieces, he goes into this, the story. He says, behold, the fowl of the air. It's as if the many birds that are in Galilee were flying over, and he saw them, and he's making what is called an illustration to those who are around him. He wants to share with them, look at the birds. It's an object lesson. Jesus calls attention to the birds. And as he's teaching, he says, behold, the fowl of the air, they sow not, neither do they reap nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Praise his name. I want to read it from the Message Bible. He says, look at the birds, free and unfettered. Not tied down to a job description, careless in the care of God. And you count far more to him than birds. Praise his name. What he's saying is that if God is taking care of the birds, don't you know he'll take care of you? Are ye not much better than they? And so he's driving this point. Why be preoccupied with worry? Why be inundated with what you cannot control? By verse 27, which of you by taking thought can add one cubit unto his stature? Why take ye thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. That if the Lord takes care of the lilies, don't you know he'll take care of you? I want you to pause right here and think about how God has kept you, sustained you, propped you up, kept you putting left foot in front of right, how God has been your protector, your guide, your director. Somebody can thank him right there that the Lord has made a way somehow, that you've been knocked down, but you weren't knocked out, that you've gone off path, but God got you back center. Yes, God still provides. God still sustains. God still makes a way. By verse 30, he says, wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Today is the day you declare, I'm going to hold on to my faith. My faith allows me to see that it's not over until God says it's over. I'm holding on to my faith because my faith tells me that he'll make the first last and the last first. I'm holding on to my faith because my faith tells me the Lord will make a way somehow. Listen. Too many people lose their faith. They are overcome with worry. They let doubt get the best of them. They are throwing the towel, brothers and sisters, but today is the day that you declare, I'm overcoming. I'm overcoming worry, that what doesn't kill me is only going to make me stronger. I'm speaking it into the atmosphere. I'm praising in spite of. The Lord will make a way somehow. The Lord will provide. The Lord will fight my battles. The Lord will handle my enemies. The Lord will turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. Can I get a witness? Anybody able to declare flat-footed today, right now, here, God will make a way somehow. I know it's all over the airwaves. They're talking about a huge, gigantic bill, the stimulus package that got passed by Congress and signed by a president. Stimulus package. It's supposed to interject new life into the lives of so many. But I came by to tell you there's a stimulus package already in this book called the Bible, and it will encourage you. It will motivate you. It will uplift you. It will sustain you. It will provide for you. You can get money, but if you're a mess, it's just more of a mess. Praise his name. Get things in order. Proper perspective. Understand where your help really comes from. I was riding in today for service, and as I was riding, I heard a selection. It was written by a young man. I had seen him in his early years, teenage years, when he would play for his father. His father and I pastored in the same area in Baltimore for several years, and this young writer came out now with another song. He's a profound gospel musician, Anthony Brown. Selection was called Enough, and I listened to the lyrics in the song Enough, and what it says is, don't let anybody tell you that you're not great or that you're not fearfully and wonderfully made. You are special, a designer's original. It doesn't matter what they say or what they do. All that matters is how you feel about you. You're amazing the moment that you think so. So don't you dare say that it's over until God says that it's done. You still have a life to live. You still have a race to run. And with each step, keep moving forward. And he'll be there for everyone. And whatever you do, don't forget, you have enough. God gave you enough. You are enough. And you will get through this. You have enough. God gave you enough. And you are enough. Somebody ought to praise God. That's the closing right here. God has already given me enough. I have enough. I am enough. God made me enough. You ought to shout that. You ought to praise God for that. That I already have what I need. That when I just hold to his unchanging hand. Trouble don't last always. Setbacks turn into setups. Stumbling blocks to stepping stones. God's not through with me yet. Overcomer. Conqueror. More than enough. That's the kind of God we serve. Listen, I want to speak to you today. I really do. I pray that you can receive this because inundated with struggle, trouble, trial and tribulation, uncertainty and difficulty, but be an overcomer. Overcome worry because God has already given you enough faith. Today, you can make a decision. It's your opportunity to say, Lord, I receive the word today, and in the midst of what I'm enduring, in the midst of what I'm experiencing, I heard the message. I'm going to overcome worry. Why? Because I'm going to hold on to my faith. Will you accept Jesus as your Lord and your Savior today? Will you let him in and let him make the difference? He's already brought you through many dangers, toils, and snares. He's already kept you in spite of you. He's already been more than enough. But today, you can yield. You can declare, I want to accept you into my life. I want to rededicate my life. The message resonated. The master has my back. That's it. Not complex, not difficult. That's it. To the point, succinct, trust in the Lord. You can make that decision today. There's information on the screen that gives you direction and options. And we want and pray that you'll let the Lord in and let the Lord do the Lord's work. And I guarantee you, whatever you're up against will be minimized because we serve an awesome God. Thank you for joining. Thank you for connecting with us today. Thank you for tuning in. Overcoming worry. God has so much more in store for you. The best is still yet to come. Be blessed until we meet again. God bless you.
Say bless, say bless, say bless. Yeah!